What's up everyone, in today's video we're going to look at the top 9 handpicked free Heroku alternative platforms that you can use in 2023 to host your backend and frontend applications completely for free. So without further ado, let's get into the video. Without wasting much of your time, I'll reveal that DataSpace is my top pick to host backend applications. They are relatively new to the market, but their offerings make them top a list. You can host both static and dynamic content through their dashboard within minutes. Data is what you covered with hosting any of your backend applications or frontend applications through their infrastructure they call as their personal cloud. The major pros of Data include no credit card verification required and free application uptime throughout the month, which is the basic requirement for any developer to host their hobby projects. The service should be free and there should be no application inactive downtime. Data offers project deployments through their CLI application and no limits on the number of builds and deployments. It supports all kinds of technologies and frameworks like Node.js, Rust, Go, or any custom backend, as well as frameworks such as SvelteKit, Next, or static applications. The only thing to note here is that it provides only 250 megabytes of environment resources, but I guarantee you that it will be sufficient for your hobby projects. The next hosting platform on the list is GitHub Pages. GitHub Pages is a free web hosting service provided by GitHub. You can easily create and host static websites built using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. They will be served directly from your project's GitHub repository, and you can use popular static website generators like Jekyll, Hugo, or Gatsby using custom GitHub actions to create your own publishing pipeline in a matter of minutes. GitHub Pages provides support for custom domains, HTTPS encryption, and easy integration with other GitHub features such as Git version control system and issue tracking, all for free. But please note that you can host websites that are built using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript only. Even if you're using custom software such as React or Next.js, your website should be exported statically to be hosted on their platform. But it is great for hosting projects such as portfolios and general landing pages. Let's move to Oracle, which is the third service in the list. Oracle Cloud's free tier has been a game changer recently. You won't believe how huge their list of free sources in the always free service is. They provide unmatched infrastructure to build and deploy your applications without worrying for usage limits. Since they will provide you with a full-blown virtual machine, you will need to set up the development pipeline and manage things yourself. But do note that it requires credit card verification to begin usage and might be overkill for small and medium projects. But it is great to get the feel of how production server deployments work. Next up on the list is Cloudflare Pages. It is a part of the numerous services provided by Cloudflare. It provides a simple way to create high-performance websites that are easily integrated with other Cloudflare services. Now, whether you are building a personal blog or a complex web application, Cloudflare Pages offers a range of features that make it a great choice for web development. Personally, I have found that static websites hosted on Cloudflare Pages load faster than those on GitHub Pages, but the tight integration of GitHub Pages with other Git features make Cloudflare Pages lose some points. Overall, if you are into the Cloudflare ecosystem and want to host some static files, Cloudflare Pages would be the way to go. The fifth platform on the list is Vercel. The platform provides the most modern user interface and experience to deploy websites and applications within minutes. It has become a popular choice among developers to use Vercel because of its performance, scalability, and serverless features. It is the best for Next.js powered projects because, of course, they created it. Their CDN is good, but if it is solely about comparing between Vercel, Cloudflare, and GitHub Pages based on CDN reliability, I will go with Cloudflare. Something that makes Vercel stand out is their excellent documentation and community support, and the fact that they provide sponsorship for open source projects. If you are looking for a complete list of pros and cons for each of the providers listed in this video, you can check out my article at genixblog.com, which will help you to evaluate and make the best pick for your project. Let's move on with Railway. It is like a copy of Heroku but with slight differences. The platform's user experience is top-notch and their pricing and restrictions are good enough to make it a viable Heroku alternative. The platform experience is very similar to Heroku, with its user interface being very modern if that matters. Like Heroku, it can deploy any kind of API or website tech stack. Also, they have great documentation to get started with. Railway has two kinds of free plans. Once verified with a credit card, it is generous enough to sustain small or medium scale projects for free. Even though they bill for resource usages by the minute, it can become expensive quickly if you pass the limits. So if you really need something that is very similar to Heroku, Railway is something that you can consider, but for better experience, I would still recommend Data or Oracle. Render is a cloud platform designed to simplify the process of building, deploying, and scaling websites and applications. It has gained popularity among developers due to its ease of use, reliability, and robust set of features. They have a generous free tier with ample resources, supporting a wide range of programming languages such as Node.js, Python, Go, PHP, etc. But a big con for Render is that even though they provide free tier PostgreSQL databases, they delete it after 90 days of creation. This does not mean 90 days of inactivity, but 90 days from the date of creation. So this makes their database services unusable without paying a fee. But overall, Render is a great fit for hosting your hobby projects. On my hunt for hosting platforms, Cyclic was a new discovery. With Cyclic, you can build, test, and deploy your applications effortlessly. Apps hosted on Cyclic do not sleep even on their free tier. Cyclic's smart caching technology delivers the best performance globally. They even have a cron job technology with 1 second precision triggering. But a big con of them is that, as of now, Cyclic supports only JavaScript, TypeScript, and Python runtimes. It is good for API hosting, but not for other type of projects. Fly is an edge computing platform that empowers you to optimize your applications for lightning fast performance and global delivery. They have a vast network of edge servers strategically placed around the world to bring your application closer to users. They also provide a generous free tier allowance to run small scale applications while supporting many languages and frameworks out of the box. Examples include Go, Crystal, Redwood.js, Dino, Ruby, etc. They also provide an in-depth migration from Heroku guide if you need that support. There are other tools that may require notable mentions such as Netlify and Firebase. They're great tools to deploy your basic front-end applications for free. And if you need final control over your tech stack, you can look into Amazon Web Services, Google Cloud Platform, and Azure, which are the leading cloud platform services. They do have service charges, but getting started on them is free. I hope this comprehensive list of Heroku alternatives helps you evaluate your options for deploying your backend and frontend applications. If you have other great recommendations, please don't forget to leave a comment on the video. Thank you.